Facebook Live, we have arrived one more time. This is who am I? Watchman Yahuda Israel, also known as Pastor Derek Mann, on the scripture study on this 30th, December 30th, 2018. Let's get in the Word. Do I have
a Bible?
Yeah, I need a Bible. Hand me that black one. Yeah, that far one. Yeah, that one. That's it right there. Thank you, sweetheart. Bless you. Bless you.
Herbert, put the moose over your head.
The moose?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, well, the moose ain't bothering me. It was his cousin. It was his kind of Santa. Is that the dude's name? Santa is the same letters as Satan. Santa is the same letters as Satan. He's rearranged a little bit. Yeah, it is. So I ain't dealing with dude. I don't trust him. Okay, what am I going to teach today? Let's go to, I guess I'm going to go to Matthew 16, y'all. Matthew 16. Look what it say. It said, then says Yahushua unto his disciples, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself, take up his struos, aka torture stake, and follow me. For whosoever will save his life shall lose it. And whosoever lose his life for my sake shall find it. For what is a man profit if he shall gain the whole world and lose his soul? Or what shall a man give in exchange for a soul? Okay, that's all I want. Yeah, that was 16 and 24. I feel like I'm about to pass out.
You need some more water.
Drink some more water.
Mm-hmm. Can you just check the blood pressure real quick, please?
Nah, I'll be all right, but I'm not
going to be all hard-headed.
I'm just going to teach. I'm already on Facebook Live. Let's just go.
Water's right there.
Yeah.
It's been attacked.
So, what will it profit the man? Is that what I said? Mm-hmm.
Yep.
No. If any man will come after me, let him deny himself.
You have some sugar?
That's what I need. Mm-hmm. My blood pressure is through the roof. That's my problem.
Is it high or low?
High. Water. As heck.
I was going to say,
you have to drink a lot of water.
Yeah.
Put some sugar in the water.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
First, you have to check your blood.
I'm going to be all right.
I know you need that water.
Hey, how you doing, Donna? Bless you. Rhea, bless you. Anyway. If any man, I can't even remember. That's crazy. If any man will come after me, let him deny himself, take up his straws, and follow me, right? Like having a relationship with the Most High, whether people teach it or not or know it or not, but to be honest with you, it's upon condition. I don't know if you knew that, right? is upon condition. Like, anytime someone preach you into a situation that like is hecka loose and it's a free-for-all, they lied to you. If you look at the state of the world and why we had the problems we do and what the solution was, if it's a free-for-all, there would have never been a pursuit of a particular people that would represent him on earth. What was that all about? He was looking for a group of people that would represent him and his oracles, that would stand out, from amongst others, right? Because that is the pursuit of fixing a wrong. So, like a mindset of, like, believing that you just grab him arbitrarily with no rules, no regulation, and no standard is a jacked up state of mind to have, because it's just not realistic, nor is it true, right? So in Matayahu 16 and 24 is offering, if a man will come after me, let him deny himself, which then will let you know the criteria to coming after him is deny yourself. And that would expose that then there's something wrong with oneself. And oneself would be the hindrance of one following him, having, you know, a true relationship with him. It takes self-denial. So if any man would come after me, let him deny himself, take up his struos, which the King James Version call it a cross, right? But you're taking up the suffering associated with self-denial. Like the word teaches, right? If he that has suffered in the flesh has ceased from sin, right? You gotta suffer in order to do what's right, right? So if any man come after me, let him deny himself. He gonna take up his struos. And he's going to follow him, right? It's a shame I have to keep reading this, right?
Read it.
For whosoever will save his life shall lose it. Whosoever will save his life shall lose it. And whosoever will lose his life for my sake shall find it. So, like, when you walk in, like, self-denial, is that the end of the matter? Because that's the criteria to have a relationship with him, right? But is that enough? Self-denial. Or did it say you got to be willing to deny yourself and lose your life for his sake? That's the key. A lot of people, like, go through self-denial, and that's just the truth. A lot of people go through self-denial for certain reasons. That's how life is, right? You want an education, you go to school, you don't feel like it. You want the degree, the master's degree, you got to study. You don't feel like it. You want the money, you want to buy the house, you got to work, even when you don't feel like it. So there is a self-denial associated with living. But this offers a self-denial associated with him. And that's the difference. And that's the rough part for people, because people is willing to go through stuff, but how many people is willing to go through stuff for him? And that's the determining factor, right? So anytime you're offered a relationship with the Most High that don't cost your cooperation and or your willingness to suffer for him directly, not even indirectly, is the type of suffering associated with self-denial for kingdom building, for him. Does that make sense? Statements like, earlier in the 16th chapter, right? It say, first seek ye the kingdom of Yah and his righteousness, right? What does that look like? what does it look like to seek first the kingdom? And what suffering is associated with that? What kind of suffering is associated with looking out for the things of Yah before you look out for yourself? What does that look like? Day-to-day operations of it, though. The day-to-day operations of first seeking the kingdom of Yah. Example. The Messiah never sinned, but yet he was finna suffer as a sinner, all the way to the point of losing his life. His flesh had opinion in his documented, I would that this cup pass from me. Because he finna die. He would be tortured, beat down, and die. His conclusion then became, but not my will, the will of the flesh, but thy will be done. Is that a perfect example of first seeking the kingdom of Yah and his righteousness?
Yes.
You're exactly right. So to what level should we be willing to go through self-denial for him? To what level? I know what religion is, go to church on Sunday. And if you cuss in the sanctuary, apologize. So I get it. I get it. I cuss when I leave this MF. I'm going to cuss you out when I get out of here. When you're offered a doctrine that's associated with what the snake offered to Eve, which is you can go against him and you won't surely die, even though he said the wage of sin is death, and he was complaining about it, right? It literally takes a self-denial, but to what level? We need to know that, or else you'll end up having a form of yahliness and denying the power thereof. You'll end up being a church person, a religious person, but you're still scandalous. You end up, okay, Corinthians, 1 Corinthians 12 offers that we're a body. Colossians adds to it that he's the head of that body. So all direction come from him. All direction come from him. His standard hasn't changed because he was the head of the body from the gate. And because we're baptized into his body in his absence, we represent his body. Has the standard changed or is it exactly the same? If we're baptized into his body, is he still the head of the body? And then the same mindset of the body is still comes from him. Has the standard, has the mission changed?
No.
Not even a little bit? I thought we were sinners saved by grace. The standard ain't changed a little bit? Since we're imperfect, we're only human, the body can cuss now? The body ain't got to heal no more? The body can pray every now and then. Can the body go to the club? Is it cool for the body to be at the strip joint?
No.
Get high and drunk and sleep with folks because they sexy and a dog. Girl, look you here. Shall I not preach because I don't feel good? What'd you think? I feel terrible. He said, if any man come after me, let him deny himself, right? It takes self-denial to live his life. You got to have a state of mind to first seek his kingdom. And he said, the stuff that you tripping off of as a man, as a woman, I got you. Shaul offered a thought, right? It said it's better to be like him, single, right? He said, because those that are married care for the things of the world, how he may please his spouse, and vice versa, right? But there's another scripture that joins that and say, those that are married, be as though you're not. So prayerfully, even if you're married, you're not unequally yoked, because who you married to cares about the things of the kingdom as well and know how to walk in self-denial. But if you are unequally yoked, you then got to stand still to obey and care about the things of the Most High, but still able to like balance the situation and still take care of your carnal family. But y'all got to be first. Number one, you got to be the type of person that first seek the kingdom. If you're baptized into his body, because I offer to you the answer, and I know all y'all know, no, the standard has not changed. He's still the head of the body. That's right. And we're members in particular, and we should be working towards one goal. Saul had to deal with the Corinthian church, the Corinthian assembly, rather, but the ecclesia in Corinth, because they were carnal. They had all kind of ism and schism going on, right? They had a thing going like, I'm of Paul and I'm of Apollos and I'm of seed division. You have folks doing their own thing, and he had to tell them, look, you still babes. You still babes. I want to share what you meet, but you're not even ready because you're carnal as heck. Everyone go their separate way. Don't know how to function as a body. You got folks that got to learn how to participate in the building of his kingdom, in the building of the ministry, learning how to love one another and go without for one another. Folks don't know how to do that. Folks don't know how to do that, especially to the level that they should. Y'all got to get to the point where he can trust you to function in the body, because some of us can function in the body as like a cancer or a virus. This is the truth anyhow. Slowing down momentum. Looking at things from a carnal standpoint. I hope y'all following. Really about, not about functioning in the body. I can't function in the body and serve myself. That's what the word offers. He said, you can't serve both Yah and Mammon. You can't serve Yah and money. You can't be the type of person that's seeking to save. If I read that part right. For he to seek to save his life, gonna lose it. Self-preservation. I'm really not about the body. I'm really about myself. And I really want Yah because I want to go to heaven. I want something from him. I'm not coming to lay my life down that somebody else might live. I came to the body so I can live. I'm about me. I sleep with it because I want to feel good. I sleep with him because I want to feel good. I'm doing me. I'm doing me, and I'm trying to get Yah to help me do me. I need some help doing me. I want him to dispatch his angel protection about me and my family. I can't give. I ain't got it to give. It's tight around me. Can I get a little help?
Going against the word.
He said, if, and I appreciate the if, because the possibility that folks might not want to come. That don't mean they don't want to come to service. But they don't want to abide by service. You got self-preservation that's reigning in the lukewarm so-called church dispensation that we're living in. We got that lukewarm thing going. How many people will get up in the middle of the night to go help somebody? And I know you would. But how many people give when they can't afford to? How many people will be nice to someone that wasn't nice to you? How many people study, fast, and pray? And could honestly say that Yah's business is more important than their own? Is that the requirement, though? Is that the standard? Is it the standard? This particular ministry has suffered, right? And it suffered because of the so-called leadership is carnal. Can I talk like that?
Yes, you can.
I can say so much. See, I get myself in trouble, sick and all. Y'all gonna have to deliver me, because...
you just tell the truth, that's all.
I have to. Yeah. Just in case my blood pressure get a little higher. And he said, come on, son. I ain't gonna go there. But anyway. There is a standard and a requirement that comes along with being a member of the body. And folks have a tendency to believe that it's just the watchman or the pastor or the leadership. But it actually is everybody. And like I've been teaching, I'm going to say it again. The standard came from, you got an example of the Messiah coming. You got John the Baptist, they call him, right? But it's really Yochanan the Immerser, right? But you got John the Baptist written of in Isaiah 40. And he was the voice of one crying in the wilderness, making the way for the Mashiach to come, right? Well, the voice was repentance. Now let's look at repentance, because if you look at Yochanan when he came, his ministry was, he was baptizing people in the name of repentance. And repentance means to stop sinning. That was the ministry, right? So the standard was stop sinning. Who was he talking to? These folks didn't even have a Mashiach yet. So people think that you're supposed to come to the Most High, graduate, and slowly stop sinning. When the truth of the matter is, the first move you were supposed to make was stop sinning. First move to receive him was to say, I ain't living like this no more. AKA repent. That's what I mean. I'm not living like this no more. Now, to maintain, like Mother just said, to maintain the mindset of I quit, you need the Ruach HaKodesh. Because the carnal mind is enmity against Yah. It's hostile. It wants to do me. It wants to have its cake and eat it too. It wants to go to heaven and go to bed with a bottle of gin and grin. Okay, whatever your drink of choice might be. Dirty water with sand in it. I don't know. But putting things in the proper perspective, when we started this, we started off with self-denial. We started off with the gospel, they call it, coming to accuse you of living your way and your way is wrong. That's the first move. And the acceptance of that is I repent. I'm not living like that. So now people have a state of mind that I'm not there yet. What the heck, yeah, what that mean? I thought you already accepted him. What you mean you're not there yet? What the heck does that mean? I'm slowly gonna stop getting high. I'm slowly gonna stop defiling my temple, smoking cigarettes and cussing. And who taught you that? He said, if any man would come after me, let him deny himself. If you ain't gotta come after me, you can be Catholicized. You can go to Catholicism. You can go to the Catholic Church. You can go where and do it moving. Yeah, you can pull that one.
What do all this mean?
Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. I used to be an altar boy. See, he made me tell on myself. Why you do that, Mother? Let's talk later. I'll call you. Okay, I helped the man push the stuff, okay? I didn't know.
You know, that's once upon a time stuff.
Thank you, Mother. Oh, you can forget that. What's wrong with that? Oh, this dude talking. If any man come after me, let him deny himself. Right? We cannot live this life unless you willing to deny yourself. You can't run around here seeing people in need and you won't help. Because you heck of carnal. Like, oh, this is so funny. It's not funny though. But everyone should participate in giving. Everybody. Everybody, can you say everybody? People be thinking like it's just a gift. Yeah, and I'm saying there is a gift of giving without question, because some people like overabundantly give, and that's their call. Some people got laying on of hands, but he can use you to lay hands if needed, because the person that really got to give ain't functioning, right? But at the end of the day, everyone should give. And it's been set in order, right? I'm giving you another secret of how to know how to rightly divide the word. When you're dealing with what they call the New Testament, right? It is not a new gospel in and of itself. It is the conclusion of the Old Testament. If it does not cohesively go back to Torah, then it ain't right, because it's nothing new. It is the revelation of the old. So that's how you, so whenever you're reading the new, you want to know what it means, you go back to Torah and find out what it really was talking about. Because so many false doctrines are created because people are trying to live by the New Testament, and you got these jokers rolling with New Testament, but it don't line up with Torah. So that's when you come up with Calvinism. You know, once saved, always saved. When the Most High kicks plenty behind, do not get it twisted. Most High will kill you. And folks don't understand that. They think he just Santa Claus. That's heck of nice and all that. He said, I reign on the just as well as the unjust. And it's an appointed time that he moves. And when he moves, people die. He kill people. When you, if you position yourself to be a devil and go against him, and then folks be thinking that, like, it's heck of different religions out here. Which one is the right one? Is they all different paths to lead to Yah? When again, the truth of the matter is, he drowned everybody except for 8 people to start over because it was heck of religions. And on the other side, the religions were still offered. He had to save the world through the line of Shem, which Abraham was birthed, because he was the only dude running around here that was believing him at his word. He called him out of Mesopotamia, amongst the Hamites, amongst even his father's house, because they was into false idol worship. They were tainted. So he called them out, said, leave them, and I'm going to take you somewhere else. And after he did that, then he entered into a covenant agreement that the Mashiach would be born through his line, and that's how the 12 tribes of Israel came. And that's why he ended up rescuing them out of Egypt, and then he entered into a covenant agreement with them in the wilderness, and they would be the nation above all nations because they would have a special relationship with him. So any other religion and any wasn't cool. So we got this old big old everything is good type of many roads to him, or there is no standard to being saved. What you got to understand is y'all don't mind killing all of us. It's not his will that any should perish. So that's why the word in Yochanan 3:16 say, for Yah so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. The everlasting life is for the believer. Folks don't know what the elect is. Who is the elect? They think he didn't chose some people to be saved, some people to go to hell, and they're the elect. Now, the elect is the believer. And destruction for the non-believer. What part of that you don't understand? False doctrine. Folks going in the New Testament don't know what the heck they talking about. But the standard has been lost. When it comes to giving, he set up a situation that the other tribes had to support the Levites. And the Levites was the one that handled the things of Yah. That was their job. How does that translate to the New Testament? Whoever is working the altar. That's why when the Grecians wasn't getting ministered to right, and they were fighting about the Hebrew women versus the Grecians, and they was, you know, partial towards the Hebrew women, and you know, some old racism type thing they were saying was going on, and it came across to the apostles, and they were saying, what, shall I leave the word, fasting and praying, and come deal with that? I need to be concentrating on the word, stand in contact with the Most High, so I can preach the word. Get some faithful folks, a.k.a. some deacons, and let them deal with that. And they still preached, because that was Philip and Stephen and all them. They were getting killed and all that for the good news sake. But their job was to handle the carnal stuff so that the men of Yah could deal with the word. So then he was teaching about the oxen, right? He said, in Moses' law, it said, muzzle not the mouth of the ox to tread not the corn. Then he asked the question to the people, did he say that for oxes? For oxen? Or did he say that for us? He said, no, doubtly for us. He that works of the altar should live of the altar. That's a Torah principle from the gate. So by right, whoever is ministering the word, that's what they should be doing. And the congregation is supposed to take care of them. Jokers don't do that. They come with $5. $50, you live off that. Good, you go. That's why Malachi told the priest, you go offer that to your governors. He said in Corinthians 9, he said, people have power over you and you pay them. And he was like, how much more us? What's wrong with you? You appreciate the restaurant more than you do the man of Yah? That carnal meal is more important to you, huh? You care more things about your personal family than the house of Yah. And it's all proven. But one thing you best believe, right, is that the Most High going to take care of his irregardless. So when I preach stuff like that, is it for me? You ain't been given and I do well. Real talk. You ain't got to get, you can get mad at me and say, I ain't giving nothing. Don't. Real talk. Paul, he took an attitude, Saul, in 1 Corinthians 9. He said, I don't want you to. So you can't take away my boasting. We got to live for Yah as individuals. We should be working together collectively, like the words say. But it's cool. It is cool. Because if you preach for filthy lucre's sake, right? You become a slave to the people because you're not going to tell them the truth thinking that you're going to mess up your offering. So I'm quick to say you ain't got to give me nothing. You don't anyway, but you can keep it like that. It's cool. But for your soul's sake, you should. If it's going to work right. When we need each other, you should show up. You should be seeking the kingdom of Yah first. He even put in order those that are married, be as though you don't. Because when you're married, you want to take care of your woman, your family. Well, he told Abraham, give me your son. Put that in order. How about that? Sacrifice him to me. And Abraham had so much faith that he was willing to sacrifice his son. And in Hebrews, it disclosed that he thought that the Most High would raise him and give him back. That's true. So he was willing to do something counterproductive to himself in the flesh. Because he believed Yah so much in the spirit. He said, if any man come after me, I'm feeling better, y'all. If any man come after me, because you ain't got to. But if you do, you got to walk yourself to now. You got to or don't. You ain't got to. Whosoever will, let him come. And don't deceive yourself and pat yourself on the back because you came. If you don't smoke as much as you used to. What, you want a cookie? Y'all remember that? Did you say that when he was growing up? What, you want a cookie? Look what I got. What, you want a cookie? Oh, you got new shoes? Look at mine all turned. What, you want a cookie? Either you're going to live this thing or you're not. What you would want to do is allow the word to come transform you. Excuse me, y'all. Mm-hmm. By the renewing of your mind, your stinking thinking will destroy you. That's what it'll do. The key. If any man come after me, let him deny himself, take up his straw, torture stake. What he was hung on, a tree. He said, take it. Get your tree and arm yourself with the same mind that the Mashiach had. And the same mind he had was his willingness to suffer. You can't serve him and yourself. Can't be done and it won't be done. Can't be done and it won't be done. And the carnal mind, I ain't gonna keep y'all long. But the carnal mind can't do it. There's a certain state of mind that we got to be able to differentiate between having a spiritual mind and a carnal mind. Because if even if it's unbeknownst to yourself, if you're abiding in a carnal mind, you'll do nice stuff, but it won't be for him. You do nice stuff and it'll be temporary. You do nice stuff, but you're not going to walk in the spirit. He said, walk in the spirit and live in it. You won't be able to live in it because you're carnal. And when you're carnal, it should be a red flag when you live for yourself. You won't take the call. You won't labor with someone. You won't labor with someone that clearly don't deserve it. You'll weigh it out, like if they deserve it or not. Because you're carnal. Oh, yeah. You're throwing the tie. I'm sick of it. Look, if they apologize, the words say if they sin against you 70 times 7, forgive them. Mm-hmm. I mean, I can teach on that a little heavier, not because I'm scared to say this for people's sake, but so I'll just say it anyway. But if someone molests your child, you can forgive them, but you ain't going to let them around your child to do it again.
That's right.
No. Ain't going to let them in your house.
Mm-hmm. It could come to the point where you can. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I guess so.
And you should. You can't answer that in your corner mind.
No, that's right.
But first move is you're going to make sure. Mm-hmm. You shall know every tree by the fruit it bear. Mm-hmm. You got to make sure they with Yah. Just like it's my responsibility, right? Dealing with this ministry, right? Mm-hmm. It's my responsibility to make sure I don't be handing preaching assignments to folks that's not spiritual.
That's right.
Because people get attracted to them spiritually mm-hmm. and start looking to them as if they represent Yah in the ministry. So I have to be, there's enough, too many people that's been in this ministry that want people towards them and then they backslide. Mm-hmm. Start giving them some authority and people start looking to them. Mm-hmm. What happened to so-and-so?
Mm-hmm. Right.
Oh, he's somewhere butt naked.
Oh, my goodness.
Pray for him.
All of a sudden.
Oh, he's back on crack. That ain't funny.
No, but it's true. Wow.
He want to preach, but he won't give a dime. He should know that by now. You don't know that yet by now? That you should give? That was some old element. That was, you don't know that? So I got to preach. Sick. How funny is that? But I'm willing to.
Hallelujah.
Your blessings come.
And I'm not complaining. Man, I'm just trying to make it. I wouldn't care if he don't give me a dime. Or I'm just trying to make it, man. Period. I want to be pleasing in the sight and do what the heck I'm called to do. And everybody on the sound of my voice should feel exactly the same way. Mm-hmm. I'm talking about exactly. Hallelujah. Not trying to study to find out what you... You don't have to do. You know, there's people that try to figure out the minimum. So if I don't do this, can I still? What?
You got people like that.
So what? That mean I got to come to service? Oh, well. Yeah, that means you got to do whatever the heck he tell you to do, and it's going to be according to the word. It's not going to be a tailor-made personal doctrine like you think. Like, if you do this good, you think you're excused from doing this. Some dumb stuff, boy. I already did so. You're supposed to be bought with a price, and your life is no longer your own. Or keep it, and then he's going to judge you. Keep it and deal with him. And it's a fearful thing to fall in the hands of a living Elohim. We got to come on. He said, if any man come after me, am I preaching false doctrine?
No.
Can
no.
somebody type something on Facebook and let me know how out of pocket I am if I'm tripping? Mm-hmm. Especially y'all to go to a fake church.
Mm-hmm.
Talk to me. Under, hey, Calvinism, they got books with new words, right? And the new words got their own meaning. So if you have a conversation with them, you sound like an idiot talking with them, right? Because they speak in a language that only they know. They got that poison spirit in them. And so, like a scripture that's plain as heck to someone that haven't studied their books, can see the scripture for what it really means. They can't see the scripture for what it means because they think they know some extra knowledge according to the books. And so you can have a conversation with them and sound like you lost. And only them and they, whoever up under that satanic spell. But yep, see? What the heck is you talking about?
They all drunk.
Up under the wine of the great whore that Revelation 17 talks about. Got the whole world drunk on the wine of her fornication. Mystery Babylon. Catholicism. False doctrine. It's time for us, and again, I'm getting ready to go, right? But if you're going to be saved, or don't. I pray you do. I'm not trying to be mean. I really pray you do. That's why I preach. That's why I'm trying the best I know how to tell you the truth, and the truth cuts. With this barely being saved stuff, it's not cool. It is not cool. Who preaches and then retire? Are you kidding right now? Oh, I'm about to retire. This ain't your personal business. You got a fictitious name. And you didn't mess around. Name the church after you. Phillips Temple. Philip, if you don't get your crazy butt up out of here. Phillips Temple. What? Is that crazy? The body already got a name that's above every name, and you praying and fasting, coming up with a name. Joker, this ain't Joe. He didn't even go to the parents. Is y'all hearing me?
Right.
He didn't even go to the Messiah's parents and say, so what y'all think his name should be? He told them.
Yes.
He told them what his name was. And he gave him the best name that ever been created. His own name. The greatest name not only in this world, but in the world to come. Yah. Yahusha. Come on, y'all. He said, if any man will come after me, because you ain't got to. If any man come after me, let him deny himself, because it's necessary, because if I don't follow him, I'm going to follow myself. And if I follow myself, I'm going to be somewhere butt naked with a bottle of liquor. Telling a lie. Period. If any man come after you, let him deny himself. Take up his torture stake, because in order to follow him, this suffering, because we got to go against this untoward generation, and this church generation is anti him. Right? If any man come after me, let him deny himself. Take up his cross and follow him. What would he say? For he to seek to save his life? I'm sorry, y'all.
That's right.
Oh, it said, for whosoever will save his life shall lose it. You want to save your life? You want to save your life, you're going to lose it. If you save your life, you're going to lose it. But if you lose your life for his sake, you're going to find it. It's not just lose your life for your man or your woman. Lose your life for your kids and your job. It's lose your life for him. So you can, look again, do not misunderstand your suffering like you're suffering for him just because you suffer and you go to church. Losing your life for him, meaning financially. Yeah. Your time. Mm-hmm. Turn the TV off and read. That's you losing your life. We assembling. You coming? No, not today. You ain't losing your life.
That's right.
You still got your life. You still running the show. You're baptized in his body, and you don't do nothing the head say. Show up or blow up. For he to seek to save his life, seeking to save your life is on the day-to-day operation, incident by incident. A situation gonna come to whether you're gonna lose your life or you're gonna let your life go and do what the heck he told you to do. He that seeks to save his life gonna lose it, but he that loses his life, I'm not gonna do me. She'll find it. Then he went on to say, for what would it profit a man to gain the whole world? You do what the heck you want to do. That's gaining the world. Come and go as you please. You stacking. What you trying to buy now? What you trying to buy? You don't give. What you trying to buy? You saving for another one, huh? Okay. He that seeks to save his life gonna lose it, but he that loses his life, his sake gonna find it. For what would it profit a man to gain the world? You stacking chips. And looking for scriptures to prove you ain't got to give. That ain't funny. For he that seeks to save his life gonna lose it, but he that loses his life, I say, shall find it. For what would it profit a man to gain the whole world and lose his soul? All right, I'm finna let y'all go, but I want to say this. I'm trying to let y'all go. But in Proverbs, it said, it's in vain to set a net in front of the bird. Proverbs, the first chapter, too, you ain't got to search. But it's in vain that you set a net to trap a bird in front of the bird. The bird watch you set it. I ain't going that way. I'm flying this way. You wasted your time. He said, so folks that live evil and don't obey him is setting a net and don't even know it. And they definitely gonna fly into it. You don't know. When you live wickedly and go against the Most High, you're setting a trap for yourself and you don't even know it. You think you're setting a trap for yourself, or you're setting up a nice life for yourself. And it don't work like that. Read it. And also in the chapter, he's talking like, and when your calamity come, I'm gonna laugh at you. Who preached that? Who tell you that the Most High will say, okay, I'm going to kick your dog on behind and I'm going to laugh at you? Mm-hmm. Who preaches in Deuteronomy 28 that he said, okay, just like I had pleasure in blessing you, you cross me, I'm going to have pleasure in tearing your head off. That was in Deuteronomy 28, Proverbs first chapter. It's a fearful thing to fall in the hands of a living Elohim. Mm-hmm. Who is saved is the believer. Those that see evil for evil, starting with the evil in themselves, mm-hmm. and willing to walk away from it, yes. and say, okay, I'm good. I'm not messing with me. I quit me. What would you have me to do? Those that want to save anything short of that, you're being deceived. Just want you to know that. Just want y'all to know that. Because I need to know it too. But this particular ministry needs some people to stand up. And you're going to have to stand up in order for me to mess with you. Because I don't want nobody else being exalted, people looking at me backslide. I don't need no one else that up.
Yes.
I can't do it. I got to repent. So do you. That we might carry the oracles of Yah. And hear him say, well done, thy good and faithful servant. Okay. And still in closing, to whom much is given, much is required.
Right.
Say you're still growing, which you shouldn't be. You should have repented as soon as you started. But say you're still growing. Whenever you're put into a position where people is looking at you, it could be in your house, mm-hmm. or it could be you're handed the microphone. There's a responsibility to come with that. You don't have the luxury of coming and speaking for the Most High, running, for the lack of better term, I use these church terms, right? Sunday school. Being an usher, working in the house of the Most High, when you on a ritual MIA schedule, I'm missing again. then you need to be quiet. Mm-hmm. And if you the type of person that weigh it out and you ain't gonna obey it out, keep coming. And we'll keep praying together. But you ain't functioning. Not in this ministry. Y'all give y'all praise because he's worthy. Hallelujah. 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 That was the message for today. Let's pray. Spirit of the Most High, we love you and thank you for this opportunity to come before you. Humblest we know how. I'm asking you to bless your children. Touch them from the top of the head to the bottom, they feed and strengthen them in you, take them higher in you. Kill the carnality that's mad right now. And bless your children, taking us higher in you, that we walk circumspectly before you, realizing that we started with repentance and we're going to end with it. And growth in you is the willingness to forsake all and anything, anybody, for the furtherance of your kingdom. With a state of mind to first seek your kingdom and your righteousness, knowing that all this other stuff, you got us. For he to seek to save his life, gonna lose it. But if we're willing to lose our life for your sake, we will find it. And we'll govern ourselves accordingly. In the matchless name of Yahushua HaMashiach, that's what we pray. Hallelujah, hallelujah, and amen. That was the lesson. And y'all, thanks for praying for me. Real talk. I feel better. Somewhat, but I'm still probably a little in trouble, but it's up to y'all. Got me, and y'all continue to pray for me as I pray for you. If y'all want to talk, we can. It is late, but 302-202-1102 extension A15648. If you want to say something, we'd love to hear from you. Other than that, if you want to sow, you can. Again, real talk, you do not have to. Please understand that I don't preach for money, and I prove that. But you can go to PayPal, put in DerrickMann5857@yahoo.com. That's DerrickMann5857@yahoo.com. If you want to hit the Cash App, 510-938-0144. And again, if you want to hang out and talk, 302-202-1102, extension 815648. Y'all be Baruch and Baraka Shalom, because I'm gone.